Sally Winward from Lifeline.
I just heard you speak. You were fabulous.
Thank you. Look, we can't afford that budget. We've already discussed that with them.
I'm Dr. Lillian Rose.
Right, right. John, let me call you back. Bye-bye. Yeah, we viewed your tape, and we really couldn't tell much from that.
That's why I want to urge you to come to my next lecture.
Right, well, why don't you just...
Now, I know that I could offer you a program that would be very cost-effective.
Well, we are looking for some reality-based shows. You got my ear. My sister was depressed. She wasn't crazy.
She had medication that she wasn't taking.
She was worried about what it would do to the baby. She was nursing.
Have you seen that before?
Yeah. I gave that to her. It's a charm to make her feel better.
How about your brother-in-law? Did you help him feel better?
We have evidence that you were in their bed recently.
I held my sister when she couldn't stop crying. When she couldn't get out of bed, much less the house. And that's a hell of a lot more than he did.
And that's your brother-in-law you're talking about?
Yeah, Jason. He hid at work day and night, leaving her alone with four kids.
Well, sounds like it was too much for her.
Yeah, they drove her nuts. Okay, yeah, she was a wreck. But there is no way in hell that she killed them.
Mother.
Sweetie, I didn't mean to startle you.
Oh.
You're so skinny.
You're so young.
Oh, honey.
Sit down.
You know, I really shouldn't be contacting you.
Yeah, look at you. You haven't changed since I was 23 when you...
died.
Yeah, I could be your mother.
Yeah, well, you're not. Thank God. Pardon me. But we're going to get everything sorted out here soon enough, because you know how it is. You never stop being a mother, no matter how old your children are. Okay. Go ahead, okay?
Oh,
run along.
Mom, I really need to talk to you.
Who's my little muffin? Go. We'll have plenty of time to catch up.
Oh, Mom, I love you.
Eat something! Hey, did you know that these things don't digest? Ever.
I knew a Francesca once.
Really? Okay, well, what was she like?
Well, she had brown hair just like you.
Nice.
She liked to wear leather.
Rare.
She was fun, yeah.
Yeah, but you know, you had to marry the blonde with the tight ass and the perky tits.
Actually, the focus of this current study is on repressed rage.
Really? So let's say you have a volunteer.
Wrong, wrong. I have to figure out a way to get you off of this. No, Michael, you are too volatile right now.
Heads up.
Hi, guys.
Hey.
Hey, our booth is empty.
Yeah, I'm just going to try Noah's office one more time.
You are obsessed with this interview.
No, the only thing I'm obsessed with is you.
Hey, guys, get a room, okay? People are trying to eat here.
You just jealous. I told you he'd do it.
Did he propose?
Yes.
Oh,
God. Does it get any better than this, huh? A beautiful city, a beautiful morning, and two beautiful ladies. Oh,
you are so full of it.
What the hell happened to you guys?
Lock the doors.
What's going on?
Just do it,
okay? All right.
Hit it, you got it?
Okay. Will somebody please tell me what is going on?
How do we know if they even made it to Atlanta?
When they...
You know what? You guys are all nuts. The whole lot of you.
Denice!
Cops, get down! Get down!
They're on their way to Atlanta. The rest are here with me.
I'm on a rescue mission. Your colleagues contacted Homeland Security this morning.
My colleagues? I mean, the guys back at Franklin Labs?
They're concerned for your safety. You're scientists, right?
Yeah. I work in the city. We have an off-site facility. Well, we had an off-site facility. Both the field house and the tower were destroyed. I'm the chief scientist on this project. I need to be involved with every aspect of it. I'm the only one who knows how the entire system works.
I've
never seen this before. It was 3 years ago.
Okay. It looks like an award.
It's no big deal.
Just another trophy, huh? Let I'm a guess. You got dozens of these things hanging in your office.
Doing some research on global warming, I wrote a paper. It was no big deal.
Who's the guy?
Guy's my dad.
I thought he was your date.
He was my date. On that particular night, he was. He was ill at the time that this picture was taken. Oh, this is really scary.
So, how you doing?
I'm doing okay. You know, just making the rounds. I just did a CSI.
Nice. Yeah, me too. So, you going out for this moment or 30s thing?
Get thee behind me!
Thank you!
Oh, okay. I can do it different.
No. We're fine. Thanks.
Right. I got you. Nice seeing you.
So, how'd it go?
Oh, great. I'm here for the audition.
Yes.
Are there any sides for me? Script pages. What I'll be reading?
No, it's improvised. You can go.
Okay.
Well, you know those two people that you met when you were kidnapped? Well, that's Max. He's some kind of crazy lunatic fan. You're kidnapping scream queens?
And I'm not actually a scream queen, because I've done a lot of other things.
Excuse
I've done like
me,
some
Denise.
Primetime stuff and the network.
Please.
Okay.
And now, it's us.
Screw that!
Okay, hold on. Hold on! I never actually died in any of my films.
I don't think...
What do you mean? Weren't you some kind of vampire? How could you be a vampire and not die?
He doesn't really care. I know it's kind of vague. But you see, yes, I am a vampire. But it was never really clear whether I was actually dead or alive. But I made the choice to play it as though I was halfway alive but under a curse. So technically, I could return back to the world of the living.
Come to think that Max is much of a stickler for the details of the original.
Oh, hey, there I am.
You are.
What is that?
Without a doubt, X.
That's Head of the Family. You ever seen it?
Something tells me I would have remembered that.
It's kind of a cult classic.
All right. If you say so.
What do you mean by that?
Well, what?
You said, if I say so.
No, I'm just saying that if that's what you say it means, then that's what it must mean. I'm not saying that you're lying, I'm just...
Just what?
Okay, well, it's just as fascinating to me what becomes what you would call a cult classic.
What do you mean what I would call?
All right, I stand corrected. What one would say is a cult classic. All right, so my movies and your movies you think are the same? Okay, let me ask you something. How many sequels have you done for your films? Let me see,
Wait, stop, I'm trying to get me! Because if they come back and you're not here, they'll kill me. Please, you're really good at it. Fuck, okay, kill them.
Wait. I would help you, except I have carpal tunnel. Had it for a few years. Autographs and stuff. I can barely even move these two fingers.
Sounds bad.
Motherfucker!
Why don't you try it from the other end?
Maybe you should just...
Okay, all right. I was considering surgery, but that's kind of a bold move.
What?
For the carpal tunnel.
A dream is just a joke. Now, you think of something during the day, and that night, you go to sleep, and all of a sudden, your head's full of pictures, and just laugh at it.
Where do you get this stuff, Jeff?
The prank?
No. No, this advice on dreams. Get it from Aunt Zerelda.
Don't talk to me about Zerelda. You know why we split up?
Why?
Tea. It was the tea. It was bitter. Oh.
I'm getting this panicked feeling that someone's searching for me. You know, I can't explain it.
You get a person whose entire life is wrapped around another person, and all their focus is on, then all of a sudden that person leaves, and it leaves a void. Now, there's somebody out there with a void looking for you. Or else you're the one with the void looking for somebody else.
Come here. Look at me.
dream. I know this place.
He got me really confused, and he made me admit that,
Admit what?
He made me admit that when I first came to Genoa City, part of me still wondered if you were telling the truth or not about the things that Ralph did to you. No, Jill, I was trying to get rid of him. Ralph is not Superman, okay? He has no better chance of finding them than we do.
Really? You better pray that you're right.
I'm coming with you, Catherine.
It's okay. We're gonna have a lovely time. Look, I gotta get to work. I'll leave you with this mess. And you just call me up with the where and when.
Okay, again, I apologize.
Oh, good. You're all here.
Hey, Mrs. Chancellor.
Hello there, my dear. I hope you're all hungry. Johnny, why don't you take your mother and step into the dining room, hopefully.
Father's looking well. This must be a recent picture, I take it.
Yeah.
If he was any other person, I'd be amazed that he would miss the holidays in such a lovely home with such wonderful people. But knowing Brock and his dedication to people less fortunate, I'm not surprised. Is there something you want to ask me? No matter how bad the consequences would have been, it never would have come to this. I want you to know how sorry I am. How much I do love you.
Enemy vessel leaving the launch.
Security sector. Security.
Sir, that was McClane. We can stop him.
Let him go.
Looks like we got away.
That was too easy.
What do you mean?
No one tried to stop us. No one's even following.
Well, maybe they don't know where we are.
No. We're missing something. Got it.
No.
What you're supposed to do is tell me the truth starting this second.
What?
How about in pieces? Finish it!
Hey, drop the gun! Drop the gun or I'll kill her!
Don't!
Shut up! 2 seconds, then she dies.
Well, Gerda, I, of course, repudiate those who would say that because the former vice president lacks a pulse in there, that makes him as the lamestream media is so very fond of saying one of the walking dead or a zombie also.
Finally, panties that stay put, that don't go where they shouldn't, that stay in place comfortably. Now, if you could just figure out what to wear over them. Fruit of the Loom. Clothes that make you feel good.
My kids and all, so anyway, I'm looking at towels or something, and I glance up, and I see this gorgeous outfit. I thought I was seeing things.
Ooh, look at this vest.
Beautiful prices.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Denice Duff, and this is a healthy tip. Ping! I feel like something should drop down into frame. All right, now, this is something that my grandfather used to do. He had to have his Entenmann's cake, but he knew he'd eat the whole box in one sitting, so he freezes it. Papa, why are you freezing the cake? He's like, because I don't really like it when it's frozen. After about 8 years, he learned to love it, but he had 7 years that would just have a little bite. He didn't love it, but it satiated mentally his desire for having cake. What I do with my husband's cookie, or if someone gives us something, we freeze it because I don't really like frozen cookies. For that you probably have some upcoming party, baby shower, wedding, grand opening, some shindig. If you've got a shindig to go to, call me up. I haven't been to a shindig. But just know that there's probably gonna be some junk food there. One of my things is, I don't like to eat junk food by myself. Like, to me, that's such a waste of calories. If I'm gonna kill my adrenal glands, I at least wanna have the joy and company of a social experience. When did we get so many amazing, delicious, awesome, awful foods? Whose awful joke was that? There was like a cow and a tree and a cabbage and a carob. Oh, that's what it was. It started with the frickin' carob.
All right, we're gonna talk about nuts today. Nuts. Now, I was a vegetarian for several years. I'm not now. If you were to eat bad fats like lard, the liver actually distributes that bad fat around the body. But when you're upping your intake of high density fats like nuts, you're actually helping your liver to help clean. A little pricey, but very worth it. Sunflower seeds, the opposite of pricey. You're craving something and you're in the market and you're shopping and you want a snack on something, or you stop for gas, and get yourself a bag of sunflower seeds. Even if they're roasted and salted, it's still better than a candy bar or a bag of chips. Now my favorite, being Italian, the Mediterranean favorite, which is pistachio. Yes, it's also very expensive, but so is being sick. Being sick is way pricier. Just get really big quantities. It's also the same thing if you have a lot of potato chips, you're gonna eat them. So you kind of wanna buy a lot of the things that are healthy for you.
I have a little arugula salad here.
With, what is that? That's red bell peppers. And I'm gonna put some pistachios in it. Go nuts! Go nuts with nuts! You don't have to be a vegetarian to enjoy the protein of nuts. Oh man, all right, I'm going in.